Good morning, Rosie and Simon. Yes, a very emotional and a very sad day in Southend today. Their beloved MP served here for almost 25 years. He was part and parcel of living here, and he was a very familiar face on the streets around Southend. And here at St Mary's Church in Prittlewell is where that funeral service will take place at 1 p.m. today. So it is a private service. It is by invitation only, but we have heard that there's a capacity of 450 people in the church, and it is going to be full. So we know that at 12:15 today, the bells here at St Mary's Church in Prittlewell will begin to toll, and then at 1 p.m. that service will start. It's a full Catholic Mass, and then we expect that to finish at about 10 minutes past 2, and then a funeral procession will take place through the streets of Southend, and we are expecting large numbers of the public to turn out to pay their respects to Sir David Amess. This is a death that has completely shocked the community. We saw in the days following his tragic death in October, there were candlelit vigils, there was moments of silence, minutes of silence held by members of the community. There were balloons being let into the air for Sir David. So we are definitely expecting those sorts of scenes today. And of course, thoughts with his family, who were completely, of course, overcome with emotion when they went to see the flowers after Sir David's killing. We are expecting, obviously, to see them here today, and they were overcome with the outpouring of support and grief from the community here, and I'm sure they're going to be very moved by the scenes that we will be seeing in Southend today. So we know that Sir David's friend, Mark Francois, will be doing the eulogy at the Mass today, and we've also heard that the Pope is giving a special message. He has written a letter which will be read out in the service today. There was indeed a rumour that the Pope would be holding the service today. That is not the case, although that would have been pretty amazing because Sir David was such a devout Catholic. But we do know that there will be a message from the Pope. Mark Francois will be doing the eulogy, and I'm sure we're going to hear from Sir David's family as well. He leaves behind a wife and 5 children and a community that is absolutely in grief at the passing of their beloved MP.
And Ellie, there's going to be another service tomorrow at Westminster Cathedral. What do we know about that?
Yes, there's another service tomorrow at Westminster Cathedral. We hear that Anne Widdecombe will be speaking. She was a very close friend of Sir David, and we're also expecting to see Boris Johnson, Priti Patel, who was or is another Essex MP, and various other MPs who were very close friends of Sir David. He was a very popular politician, very popular cross-party politician in the days following his death. I spoke to Wes Streeting, who is Ilford's MP. He's a Labour politician, and he just spoke so very highly of Sir David and said how loved he was in the House. I'm sure we're going to see those scenes tomorrow for a full Requiem Mass in Westminster tomorrow for Sir David, who was a devout Catholic. And it is a very, very sad occasion, both today at the private family and friends funeral that we see today, the public procession that we'll see this afternoon in a horse-drawn carriage. It's a very East End style, we're told, this horse-drawn carriage. Sir David was born in the east of London, so that's a very fitting tribute. And then tomorrow, that public procession in Westminster, that funeral with various politicians. It's going to be a very moving 2 days, and full respect for Sir David.